Sometimes a dog's gotta do what a dog's gotta do when it comes to finding some shade so that he can take a nap in it. The Riverton Raiders visiting the Rollins Generals for a doubleheader. Top of the first, Riverton batting. Brody Beers is going the opposite way into right field, and he's going to find plenty of room as that ball will go all the way to the wall. He'll end up with a triple and an RBI as Nick Esposito scores to give the Raiders a 1-0 lead. Next batter, Seth Martinson will bounce into the fielder's choice. Nice hustle by the Rollins shortstop, Adam McFarland. He'll get the out at first, but Beers will score on the play to give the visitors a 2-0 lead. Bottom of the first, A.J. Vizcaino is on first for the Generals, and I should say he was on first because Riverton has him picked off. Beers applies the tag, and that took care of that scoring threat. Same inning, this time Brendan Gamelli is on first, and he's going to get taken out as well as Esposito and Sean Rivera team up to take him out. Not the best way to end an at-bat, but the opposition will take it any day. Top of the second, the Raiders are going to get a dose of their own medicine, maybe. Josh Parker is caught in a rundown between first and second. Rollins was trying to close the door on the trap, but the throw to second was off the mark and into left field for an error. Parker's going to turn the corner and press his luck towards third base. The Generals misfire again. Not the most orthodox way to score from first base, but Riverton will take the free gifts anytime, and they're now up 3-0. Top of the third, the visitors were pulling out all the tricks. Runners on the corners. The throw to second is not in time. Dalton Crane will complete his end of the double steal and score, and the visitors were out to a good start, leading 4-0. Top of the fourth, it's now 5-0. Vizcaino gets the strikeout with a runner at third to end the inning. Actually, under the circumstances, he did pretty good. It's just that his defense did not provide much help at times. Bottom of the fourth, Johnny Souza pitching for Riverton, and he had a better day than his counterpart. A complete game, 7 innings, punching out 6. He'll take that any day. Top of the seventh, the Raiders were looking for a little insurance. Leif Crumlin bounces into the fielder's choice. The Generals choose to get him out at first, but it got the job done as Parker scores to give his team a 6-0 lead. Bottom of the seventh, we had a hard time on this play because we did not know where the ball was. We just gave up trying to find it because we had to give Gemelli his credit for an inside-the-park home run. That was the only offense that Rollins could muster in this game as they came up on the short end of the stick, 6-1. On to game two, and hey, that's my ride. Looks like I'm walking home. Top of the first, McFarland pitching for the Generals, and he got out to a good start. Leaving runners on base will put an extra spring in your step any day, and there's no damage on the scoreboard. Bottom of the first, the home team would draw first blood. Gemelli will bounce to the fielder's choice, but he did what he was supposed to do. He's out at first. Kevin Cox scores, and the Generals would enjoy a 1-0 lead through the first 2 innings. Top of the third, Riverton would reach into their bag of tricks. Here comes a suicide squeeze. The run is in already. That was Souza, by the way. All that Baylor Beers had to do was get the ball into play, and he did. This game is now tied at 1 run apiece. There was more to come. Parker is on third, and he's going to steal home as the Rollins catcher could not handle the pitch. That's one way to build some momentum. The Raiders take a 2-1 lead. Bottom of the third, the home team was trying to get back into it. Vizcaino with the single to right field to get on base. The runner at third held up because he did not know if that ball was caught or not. The Raiders commit an error on the throw home. Now the runner takes off, but the defense would recover in time as Seth Martinson would apply the tag, and that ended up saving a run, and it would end the inning. Bottom of the fourth, more defense. Brody Beers to Souza to Baylor Beers for the 6-4-3 double play. Riverton was clicking. Now they just had to get the bats going, and they would later on. Top of the fifth, Baylor Beers gets it going with a single to left field. Esposito's going to hustle his way around two bags and make his way to the plate to give his team a 3-1 lead. Moving ahead, it's now 4-1. This is where things were starting to fall apart for Rollins. We're not going to show you every error they made, but you'll get the idea. Martinson will cash in on this mistake as the visitors would go up 5-1 at this point. Bottom of the fifth, it pays to pay attention to the situation. A base on balls is not an automatic free pass in from third. Credit to Rollins' defense. The team's very young and inexperienced, but you got to make smarter plays than that. Bottom of the sixth, here comes a better effort. Dean Samoda makes a contribution with a single up the gut. Vizcaino's given it all he's got, and he will try to make his way home from second base. He's going to try to elude the catcher with a little circus stunt, but it does not work. We'll give him an A for effort, though. Top of the seventh, and, well, take our word for it. it's just not worth showing because it's error-plagued, and we're going to spare the Generals the embarrassment. Riverton would push 12 runs across the plate when the dust settled, and the Raiders would get the doubleheader sweep, winning the second game 19-1.